Okay? Welcome to the future, and the future is innovation. Innovation has become a recent buzzword. Everybody talks about it. CEOs love talking about innovation to imply there is a growth even when there is none. So let's take a look at some technologies that will make this future possible. So the first one that comes to mind is big data. Big data will completely change our lives, and soon, for example, pharmaceutical companies will be able to design pills just for you based on your particular DNA structure. What else? Artificial intelligence and robotics will come very, very soon. In fact, we already see Google self-driving cars around us. Next, we're going to see Google self-driving airplanes and Google self-driving bicycles, maybe. So that is certainly happening soon. What else? Next that comes to mind is maybe nanotechnologies. Nanotechnologies are great because they will allow us to create products and devices that we never thought would be possible. I hope that one day we'll be able to implant chips into each baby's head so that we can keep an eye on our children without actually being there. We can control what they do, what they eat, who they play with. So all of this is happening very, very soon. But before all of this happens, let's look back a little bit and revisit how good are we at predicting what will actually happen. How good are we at saying which technology will succeed and which one will not? Are we just betting like in a casino, or are we making educated guesses? Let me give you a couple of examples. One is Albert Einstein. So he is a smart man, as you can imagine, and he once famously said that there is no way in hell we will be able to control nuclear power. And here is another gentleman who is also a smart person, CEO of Digital Equipment Corporation, who famously proclaimed that nobody would need a computer in their home. So both of them were obviously wrong. But let me give you some more recent examples. These are four products. If I were to ask you to bet on one of them, which one would you bet on? I bet you nobody would bet on these goofy sandals, which is actually the only product that ever succeeded. The other three failed, even though they were supported by some of the greatest companies out there. So why does this keep happening? Why do we suck so terribly at predicting technological innovation? I have a hypothesis. I think this is because we think too much about technology and we don't really think enough about business models that makes this technological solution economically viable. Let me give you an example. Think about Thomas Edison. You all know this gentleman who, as you know, invented electrical lamp, right? But did you know that there were 22 other people who invented electrical lamps at the same time with Thomas Edison? So why is he considered to be the inventor and not the other 22 guys that we've never heard of? Well, turns out Thomas Edison invented much more than electric light. He invented the business model of electricity the way we know it now. He thought that someone will have to produce electricity, transform it, transport it, charge people for it, and then, oh yeah, there is a light at the end of the tunnel, but that's a small piece of the puzzle. This is not the main thing. In fact, if you think about it, and you look at the technology, the way it evolved, we don't use Edison's lamp anymore. We don't use Edison's electric generator anymore. Now even Homer Simpson can manage a nuclear power station. But the business model is still there. We are still pretty much using the business model that Thomas Edison invented. So this is what I would call a business model innovation. This is a different approach to innovation, the one that does not necessarily rely on creating new technologies or products. This is an innovation which is about changing the way we provision products or services to the market. And Thomas Edison is not alone. There are many, many, many companies out there that innovated business models. Here are some examples. All of those companies, Toyota, Ford, Uber more recently, Kickstarter, they did not really invent any new technologies or products. They innovated business models of their respective industries. And there are companies right here in Singapore that continue doing so. These are some of the companies that I work with. One is Redmart. That's a company that innovates the way we shop for groceries. Edit Suites is innovating the way we order custom-made clothing, and Lookbooker innovates the way you book appointments for hair, spa, salons, etc. So this is happening right now, right here. What is the difference in innovation approaches? How different it is? Let me give you another example. Think about Apple. Apple is famous for its new products and technologies. Apple takes huge amounts of R&D, plunks it into research, and in complete secrecy develops products from time to time, and then produces huge quantity and inundates the market through many, many middlemen. Let me give you an alternative. Xiaomi used to be a small startup in China, now fast-growing company, which produces in small quantities, listens to users, elicits their feedback, changes product very, very often, tests the markets, and allows the users to change the phone the way they like it. These are two differences in approaches: business model innovation versus product or technology innovation. Business model innovation is transferable across industries. You can learn from each other. It's possible to describe and learn this approach. It relies on laws of economics. It's sustainable, and it does not require a lot of research and development efforts or money. So you can choose for yourself. If you decide to go with business model innovation, what would you do? Well, the first step is to audit your current business model of your company. Companies rarely do this. They love auditing their financials, but they never audit their business models. And if they did, they would have discovered that probably a business model that they invented long time ago has a huge number of inefficiencies and doesn't work well. Many of them end up in a situation of underpant gnomes from South Park cartoon, when in phase one they collected underpants hoping to get profits in phase three, but everybody forgot what happens in phase two. If this looks like your company, then you will really, really enjoy reading my recent book. It's called The Risk-Driven Business Model, Four Questions That Will Define Your Company. Visit our website for the book. Tell me about business model innovations around you. And thank you for listening to my talk today.
Well done. That was awesome. Thank you.